rose flavored things should not exist. Like, they just shouldn't. Oh my god.
Welcome to Bodrum, Turkey.
It's a very nice day, very hot, and we only have about...
I don't know, we got like 5 hours.
5 hours.
We got things to do. We've been to Bodrum before. We've done the beach thing. We've done the beach club on the chair, soaking in the sun thing. But today...
we're doing it a little different.
A little different. We're going to look for all the best Turkish street foods and see how many we can find in the time we have.
So we have a list, which we're probably going to put on the screen, of things that we are hoping to consume in the next 5 hours.
All right.
I don't know if we can do it.
We'll see.
I'm hoping we can.
We'll find them. Let's go.
We're going to try. Okay. So we found the first two Turkish foods on our list, and we decided to sit down because it's hot.
We jumped into the very first place that had any of the foods that we were looking for. This is just an open air cafe. They've got the big spits with the meat and the chicken for the doner kebabs. Crossing our fingers on these, we're gonna knock two out at one stop.
First on the list, doner. Cut right off the chickens on the spit, right? You can go with the bread or a pita, and we just went with a tortilla. So let's see. Super fresh. You get that kind of like barbecue-y taste. Barbecue-y, that's the word, right? That barbecue flavor to it where it's crispy on the outside. For me, like with things like this, I like sauces on it. So like if I had some kind of sauce to put on it, I think it would be like perfect. Once you get down further into the wrap, it does have a little bit of lettuce and it looks like some tomato in there. The chicken is really good. Like you can taste the quality in it, which I think is important because with something like this, there's not a lot to it. So if the chicken isn't cooked right, it kind of like ruins the whole dish. This is good. This is a good first stop.
So a pide is very much known as a Turkish pizza. You can get tons of different toppings, egg, meats, cheeses, different things. We went with the Turkish salami and cheese. So it's very reminiscent of like an American style, Italian style pizza for the world. I think the more traditional ones with the chopped meats are what I think of, but this is really good because the Turkish salami is very much like pepperoni. Very Mediterranean, the bread's good. Off to a good start. All right, one of the most well-known and most eaten street foods in all of Turkey is the simit. It's a sesame seed encrusted bagel-like bread. I really like these. This one's from a very nice bakery with a million sweet treats, as Katrina says, and somehow we didn't buy any of them, but we got this. This is one of the best ones I've ever had, honestly. It's super toasted. It's fresh and squishy in the middle. Neither of us are huge fans of sesame seeds necessarily, but we both came to Turkey and really liked these simits.
Oh my god. Okay, yeah, this is the best one I think I've ever had. It's super fresh and like super fresh and like spongy and soft. I want to go back and try more stuff from that bakery. Like if a simit, something super simple, is this good? Wow. Okay, we're on a roll now. Next one on our list, this is called borek. It's really flaky pastry dough that has filling inside of it. You can get it with spinach and cheese. We saw one that had sausage and some peppers in it, and we went with the potato filled one. I haven't had this before. We went, you know, a week in Turkey and haven't tried this yet. It's very warm. It is also from that same bakery that we were just at, so I have some high hopes for how good this is going to taste. So let's see. There's like a spice in there that I wasn't expecting. I thought it was gonna be more just like hash browns or like a just regular boiled potato, but there's some kind of like Turkish spice or something in there. It also has toasted sesame seeds on top, which again, Nate mentioned we're not huge fans of, but it kind of adds to the depth of flavor in this. Ay, ay, ay. Pastry dough is super flaky. I like it. I actually wouldn't mind trying one that has like spinach and cheese in it. What's that spice? Approved.
So a little behind the scenes here at Nate and Katrina Do the World headquarters. I don't know.
Headquarters out of Bodrum today.
Yeah, we needed another simit to get a potential thumbnail so that you would click on this video, which you did, and so we needed to go and get one so we wouldn't got one over at this stand. 10 Turkish lira. That's not much money. They're very cheap. You
know, try it. What is that in USD?
I don't even know. I'll put it on the screen. I work in euros nowadays.
I'd like to take a photo of it.
Okay. Even more behind the scenes.
So we're off the beaten path a little bit, so communicating is a little bit harder over here, but I think we're getting a cheese gözleme. We figured out that this particular Turkish food is probably more of the breakfast variety. It's about 2 o'clock in the afternoon right now, so I think that's why we're having a little bit of a challenge trying to find this particular one.
This is literally a Turkish quesadilla. It's Turkish bread, which I love, and then I still don't know what exactly the type of cheeses they use here, but that's what it is. So it's hot, it's fresh. I really appreciate the icy glass, like kept in the freezer for my Coke Zero. It's warm out here. Absolutely great. Let's try this thing, shall we? I was thinking I was eating this with my hands, but I have a fork and knife, so I'm gonna be civilized. Excellent. I love Turkish bread. I buy it in the supermarkets in Holland sometimes and just make like sandwich wraps out of it. This is right up my alley. It's simple. All these tomatoes and cucumbers for Katrina. We're in good shape.
I think this is my most favorite thing that we've tried so far. It's like very pillowy. I mean, that bread is super fresh. Hot. You can tell they just made all of this, like, probably this morning, made the bread and everything. Ugh. This is a good find.
All right, so we went to this awesome little cafe that had a bunch of different snacks, including baklava, and the baklava looked really good. We got some to go, cute little box. So we're gonna open it up. We got 3 different types, 2 pistachio-based, 2 and then 1, math is hard. 2 pistachio-based, 1 is walnut, I believe. Because Katrina's not a huge fan of pistachio. Big reveal, you ready? Oh, it's falling all apart. All right, so pistachio, walnut. I actually love these kind with the little like stringies. They're really good. Let's dig right into kind of the classic. One big bite. As I get older, honey is one of my favorite flavors. It's such a simple thing, but I love the taste of honey. Baklava is obviously very thin pieces of phyllo dough. Layers of honey, layers of pistachio. Baked, it's awesome, it's good. It's one of my favorite things in Turkey and in Greece. I'm a happy man.
Unlike Nate, I am not the hugest fan of baklava. Pistachios are not my favorite, so I usually try and find the ones that have walnuts in it, or sometimes almonds. Almond ones are really good. They had one in there. God, the honey on this is crazy. They had one that kind of looks like shredded wheat a little bit, but this does have walnuts in it, so I'm going to give this one a go. It looks really good. Like, look at the shine from all the honey just like dripping down. I wish that they made this one with the phyllo dough. It's an interesting texture with the little like hay wrapped around it. I like it, definitely tons of honey. Honey is also not my favorite thing. One reason why I just do not like baklava. I feel like the honey near the Aegean Sea is different. Greek honey, Turkish honey. I'm a fan. This is good.
He's shy. He wants my food, but he does not want my pets. Food? Pet? Food? Pet? No.
One of the last and maybe most important things that we needed to find here in Bodrum, Turkey is
Turkish delight. You guys are not familiar with Turkish delight. It is almost like a jelly, gummy, different flavor type of Turkish treat that they have all over the country. And they come in different types of flavors, ranging from rose petals, almonds, peanuts. Love your show. I'm gonna try one of these kind of simpler looking ones. Unsure what the flavor is. Looks like a kind of like a powdered sugar on the outside, but you can see it's very squishy. Kitty cat. I'm hoping it's not, oh God, it's rose. I can't.
I'll come up.
Rose flavored things should not exist. Like, they just shouldn't. Oh my God. Okay, first one fail. Hopefully this isn't with something yellow that I hate. Banana. Oh my God, it's banana. Just kidding. It's lemon, super citrusy. It has almost like a spiciness to it. Maybe it's lemon lime. Good, chewy, simple. These are dangerous because when you find a flavor you like, it seems like you could just keep popping them. I'm gonna let Nate try these other flavors because he picked these and I know that I will not like them. Coconut, pomegranate. I have a very fine palate.
Picky.
Ew, is that rose too?
All right, I'm a pretty big fan of Turkish delight. I like these big thicker ones where they cut them with the scissors. Yeah, this is pomegranate, I believe, covered in almonds, hazelnuts. I think it's hazelnuts. It's good. It's super rich, flavorful, fruit tasting. It's a lot right now. We've eaten a lot of food. Anyway, they have these little guys that are covered in like, I don't even know what those are, little sticks. It's good, crunchy. This is not what I imagined Turkish delight when I was a kid reading Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. I don't know. Turkish delight seemed like it'd be super like foreign and weird and strange when I was a child in the United States. It's kind of just gummy candy. Good stuff. So we found quite a few of our foods in Bodrum that we were looking for, but maybe not everything.
It's interesting. There was a lot more restaurants here than I think kind of the street food type vibe that we were looking for. So we missed out on a couple.
We could have probably gotten the kumpir.
Something like that.
It's a big baked potato, super common in Turkey. I couldn't eat anymore. I saw it, they didn't look like they were cooking them quite yet, so I didn't want to wait, and we kind of blew by it. And then the Turkish ice cream where they dangle it in front of you and take it away 15 times, you know.
There wasn't that many. There was maybe like three the whole time, and we're like, oh, we'll get it at the next one, and then we failed.
We failed. But other than that, we had a good quick trip outing here in Bodrum, got to get back on the boat.
And if you haven't watched our cruise videos yet, go watch those and subscribe.
Do it.